Welcome back to Cooking with Tris, real food for real people. Today, we're cooking another absolute classic. And I think it's only fair that as I live in France, that we add something French to the channel. And that's exactly what we're going to do because today we're going to be making some incredible beef bourguignon. Now, I love to cook this dish just as much as I love to eat it. It is perfect for an occasion. It's great at the weekend, on a lazy Saturday afternoon, or for Sunday lunch. This is slow cooked, so I think it should be slowly eaten as well. Get your friends round, open a couple of bottles of wine, and really take your time to eat this. It's delicious, it's well worth it. It's packed full of flavour, it's really satisfying, and yeah, it is really good. So good, in fact, that I actually cooked this for Christmas Day this year, and it went down an absolute treat. It was perfect. It's so easy to cook as well. That's the other thing that makes this a great dish. It's all done in the one pot here. Fairly simple ingredients. Ingredients that aren't going to break the bank. So it kind of ticks every box, really. And I think you're really going to enjoy eating it. And I think, again, you're really going to enjoy cooking it as well. So what have we got in it? Well, to start off with, we've got 750 grams of steak, like casserole steak or stewing steak. We also have, hiding away here, 180 grams of smoked bacon. We've got 200 grams of button mushrooms, 3 large onions under here, 2 carrots, 1 leek, and then just to finish off at the end, we've got some parsley. Oh, and I nearly forgot, we've also got some rosemary. We're going to add that in just to give it a real boost of flavour. And not forgetting some garlic here. I've got about 2 cloves worth. Then to make the sort of sauce that goes with it, I've got a whole bottle of red wine. Now this wine is definitely not for drinking. It's perfect for cooking. Cheap wine is absolutely fine. Do not waste money in buying an expensive bottle of wine for this, because we're going to burn off the alcohol and we just want the kind of flavours there. To go along with that, I've got a pint, or just over 500 millilitres of chicken stock, and then just supplementary things. We've got some salt and pepper, and then we have some flour, because what we're going to do, we're going to flour the meat before we brown it off. That's just going to help to thicken the sauce and add extra flavour there. So that's it. And if that's it in terms of ingredients. And then the only other thing is we need the biggest pot we've got in the kitchen. So I've got my old cast iron pot here, which is perfect. So that's it. Really easy to cook. Really straightforward. We're just going to need some time, really. And yeah, looking forward to cooking it. Right, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to cut everything up, and I'll be back with you in just a second. Okay then, I have everything chopped up. I've got the carrots, the leek, and the onions here, and they're really ridiculously roughly chopped, as you can see, like so. I'm gonna leave the mushrooms whole because they're quite small. If they're bigger, I'll probably cut them in half, but whole is fine for this one because of their size. Chopped up the bacon into sort of, you know, big chunks, big lardons, as it were. And what I've done, I've just got about a cup of flour, and I've mixed that with just some salt and pepper. And then what we're gonna do is grab a sieve, put it over the meat, and then just pour over, I'm probably not even gonna need this whole cup. Yeah, there you go, just about half. Just gonna pat it over. So there's a lot there, pour a bit of that. Like so, so the meat is well and truly covered. I'm just gonna get my hands in, show you here, and just really turn that over So all the meat is well covered with this flour. As I was saying, the reason for this is that it's going to keep in the flavour of the meat, and it's going to actually thicken up the sauce or the stew later on as it cooked. So that is that done, all covered like so. I'd say, yeah, got a bit extra there, so put a bit more on just in case. But half a cup of flour, or glass of flour in this case, and that'll do. This amount of food will serve 4 people really well, 6 probably really well as well. And in terms of side dishes for this, I'll probably make some mashed potato, but you can serve it with peas, well, anything you like really. But for today, I'm just gonna go for some simple mashed potato because it's quite substantial with all the different veg in there. So that's it. I've got the pot on with some oil in it, just heating up there, and then let's start cooking. We are ready to go. As I mentioned, I have some oil in my pan here. It's been heating up for a good while now, a few minutes. So we are going to start off with adding our bacon. Just gonna put this straight in there, start sizzling away, and just start moving around. Just add some colour. Now the reason we add the bacon first is because it's going to produce some of its own oil, add this really good flavour, which is going to just be cooked into the beef and then the vegetables themselves. So it's a great way to start this. So just turn this around. And yeah, as I say, we're just going to brown this up for about a minute or 2 minutes, just till it starts to crisp up. Okay, so this has really started to crisp up, and I'm really happy with that. So I'm just going to take it out of the pan and just put it to the side. That's left a load of oil there, which is just going to be great for the beef when we put it in. There you go, you can just see it nice and crisp up. So you may want to turn up the heat here, because we're going to need a lot of heat underneath to cook or brown off this beef. So I've just turned up the heat a bit. It's starting to smoke a little bit. I'm just going to add the beef in here. If you've got a heavy bottom pan like I have, you should be able to put it all in because it retains loads and loads of heat. If your pan isn't as thick bottomed, you may need to do this, say, half at a time. So do one half, brown it off, then do the other. But I'm pretty sure with this pan, it's so big and heavy, it will do the lot. So I've just got it in there and just going to give it a quick turn around. And basically here, we are just browning off. We're just adding a bit of colour. We're not trying to cook it or anything like this. It's simply to lock in that kind of flavour inside it, so when we cook it for a long time, it's going to retain that flavour and taste really good. So this should take 2 or 3 minutes, just gently turning over each piece until it's browned off. So it's been, say, 3 or 4 minutes now, and I'm really happy that the beef has started to really brown up. It smells absolutely gorgeous. So again, like the bacon, just going to take this out and put it to one side here, like so. During this process, if you have to add more oil to the meat while it's browning, feel free. Don't want it to sort of stick too much on the bottom, but don't worry if you've got this residue down here, like I'll just show you, like this, because we're just going to put the vegetables in there, the carrots, leek, and onion, and they'll really pick up that residue. So it's all good. I'm just going to turn it down quite low here, and just add a little bit of water, just to loosen things up on the bottom. Just a little splash there, like so. I'm just going to turn everything around. And we just want these to sweat down just a little bit to pick up all the kind of residue that's on the bottom there and grab all this flavour. Even now, just by adding that water, it's smelling absolutely fantastic. So I'm going to leave that like that for a few minutes. I'll grab the lid, put that on, let it build up some steam to wilt down a bit, and that's going to be perfect. It is 2 or 3 minutes later, and all the vegetables have started to sweat down, but most of all, they've really picked up all the residue at the bottom there, and they're well covered with that. So because they're so chunky, they're not really going to sort of break down at this point. It's going to take the long and slow cooking process to soften them all up, but that's fine. As I say, they've done their job there. Next thing we do, we add our meat back in, so the bacon and the beef. We just pour that in, add any juices or oil that's built up on there, like so. Give this a good turnaround, really mix it together. Wow, this is looking absolutely fantastic. And then we add a bottle of wine. As I say, do not drink this. It's red, but that's about all that it's got going for it. But as I mentioned before, do not use an expensive bottle of wine for this. We are just looking for the flavour here, not anything else that it brings to it. So cooking wine will do. You're not going to drink it, but trust me, adding this is going to really make a difference to the flavour. And I'm simply going to pour the entire bottle in. It would make me too sad if this was an expensive bottle of wine. I couldn't stand it. So there we go, that's gone in. And then we'll add our rosemary just on top there. Oh, I nearly forgot. I forgot our garlic. Probably should have put this in earlier, but we'll just put it in now. I'm sure it will be absolutely fine. So that's all that added. And then we're going to bring this up to the boil, because what we'll need to do is boil this away and burn off all the alcohol. So this will take a while, I'd say 10 minutes. Let's bring it to the boil, and then we'll check on it then and see how it's going. Okay, so our beef bourguignon is boiling away and we are burning off all that alcohol. If I smell it, you get a really quite pungent, sharp smell up your nose. So you know that that alcohol is being burnt off or evaporated, as it were. So we're gonna keep it at this boil until I don't get that sharp smell in my nose. God, it's, you can tell, trust me, there's a difference between the smell when the alcohol's being evaporated and when it's gone. So we're going to keep this going for about, it's probably going to take, I would say, 5 or 6 minutes, maybe a bit longer. There's no definitive arc to this, but I'm going to keep on smelling it. Once that kind of sharp, pungent, fermented smell goes, I know that all that alcohol is going to have been burnt off. We've used a whole bottle of wine here, so it's going to take a little while, but we need to get rid of it because we don't want that alcohol in there. We just want the flavour that it's going to bring. So let's see. It is about 9 minutes later and the wine, I reckon, has finally evaporated. That kind of sharp smell has gone. So I'm pretty sure that that's gone. It just smells really good now. So I'm really happy with that. It's reduced down a little bit, so we can tell that a lot of the liquid has gone with the alcohol as well. But that's fine, because we're going to add our pint of chicken stock. So we're just going to pour that on top, any kind of residue we bring out there. Give it all a good old stir to make sure that there's nothing stuck on the bottom, and then drop our mushrooms in, stir them in a little bit, and we are good to go in terms of putting this in the oven. So just grab the lid, put that on top, and we're going to put this in an oven. However it will go, this is going to be quite low to the bottom because the pot's so big. We're going to put it in there for about 3 hours at 170 degrees. And that's going to give it a chance for everything to cook down, the meat to tender up, the sauce to thicken up, and the vegetables to soften as well. It is 3 hours later, and the kitchen smells absolutely amazing. I've been sitting here with such anticipation to get this beef bourguignon out of the oven. So let's do that now. Here we go. Let's see what it looks like. Wow. It is looking really, really good. The smell is amazing. I'm just gonna get in here and check the meat to see how tender it is. Find myself a big chunk. I'm just using a fork. I'm just gonna pull it apart. And if I can pull it apart with a fork, which I can do, though you probably can't see that there. I'm just gonna get myself a bit here. It's really tender. It's still got a little bit of chew to it, which I really like. If you want it melt in the mouth, keep it in there for a bit longer, but for me, that is just about perfect. Just gonna give it a stir. I'm liking the consistency of the kind of sauce and everything. So this is looking great. Just got to take out these rosemary sticks. There may be a few stuck in there. And then, I nearly forgot, adding our roughly chopped parsley. So I'm just going to drop this in and then give it a really good stir. So the parsley is well covered, like so. Then finally, grab my spoon, check it for seasoning. To say that is pretty bang on. I don't think I need to add pepper or salt to that. I'm quite happy. So that's it. How awesome is that? I'm so excited to eat this. I cannot wait. I'll see you in a bit. Here is a gratuitous close-up just to show you how good this looks. And believe me, it looks great, but it tastes even better. So happy with that. Here is some mash that I prepared earlier. So this is going to be the perfect side dish for this meal. It's really good with crusty bread, anything that's going to soak up that amazing gravy that we've made. I'm going to put this in the oven quickly just to brown off the top, and it's going to be absolutely wonderful. Just to show you, here it is straight out of the oven. Maybe one day we'll do a video on making mash and side dishes. And here we have it. Fantastic beef bourguignon, a French classic. And let's see how it tastes. I'll grab some meat here. Oh, if I can. Delightful. The meat is just so tasty. As I say, just got that little bit bite to it, but really soft, and the gravy is just so packed full of flavour. It's amazing. Let's try mushroom. You're gonna love making this. You're gonna love eating it. Even better. And it goes perfectly well with the mash that I've made. So, on that note, cheers all. I'll see you soon with more Cooking with Triss. Real food for real people. Cheers. Take care.